Put your hands together for Ruel. Welcome back.
Thank you. This is my fourth or fifth project experience.
Aww.
Yeah.
You get a medal.
Best one.
Yeah. I should get a prize at this point.
Yeah. Hey, right off the back, we've got to pick a bone with you. We just heard part of that incredible new song of yours, but we can't find it on Spotify. How do we listen to
it? Well, I mean, that's the point. So, I'm working together with Lifeline on this initiative called the Release Line, where the only way to listen to the full thing is by donating to Lifeline as little as $5 by calling a specific number, which is the Release Line number, which I think you guys
have there. We'll get to that later.
Anyway, yeah. But yeah, you can't listen to it yet. It's exclusively for Lifeline on that other side of the phone.
Wow, who would have thought of buying music?
Yeah, I know, right?
Oh, it's just incredible.
Look at you, you're cheapskates. Come on. Haven't heard it yet.
Last time you were on the show, mate, you were about to head off on your world tour, Global Domination. Are you exhausted?
Yeah, kind of. I've been back for a week now after, like, almost 70 shows of the year. So I feel great, though. I'm, like, very happy to be home. I'm home for a while now and I can just get stuck into working on the next thing, relaxing a little bit, and yeah, I'm happy to be back.
Well, last time you were on, you told us a great story about almost getting kidnapped in Manila.
Oh my God.
Anything exciting like that on this level?
I don't think anything can top that in terms of like fun little anecdotes. Like, I don't have anything cooler than that. But the only thing that kind of comes to mind that was in the same sort of vibe, well, it's another driving story. We were driving on the highway in between Texas and Washington, I think it was a long drive, and I woke up and the trailer, which had all our gear for the whole tour, was on the other side of the road, suspended up a hill, about to tip over. It had come detached off the trailer of the back of the bus.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah, there it is there. We've got to send a little video. And it flew over like 8 lanes of traffic and avoided all the cars, half of that, thank God, and all our gear was just mangled for the rest of the year.
I feel like the universe is trying to tell you something.
Yeah, something about traveling. Don't travel.
Normally musicians just smash one guitar at a time.
Oh, yeah,
just
exactly.
Got a full trailer of
Yeah, it was a scary time, but hey, no one was hurt and all the gear was replaced, so it's all right.
Oh, well, that's it. Yeah, if you can get it replaced, why not?
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, do you mind if I just go back to the Lifeline?
Yeah, of course. Thing?
Why did that matter so much to you?
Well, I mean, Lifeline has been around since way before I was born. And when I think of organizations that, you know, focus on mental health, I think of Lifeline. And when I think of a place that, you know, maybe I would, if I was feeling down or didn't feel like I had anyone to talk to, Lifeline is the first thing that comes to my head. So when they reached out, it was just a no-brainer. I thought it was my duty to do something. And it just felt like such a new and cool thing to be a part of, just writing a song specifically for them. Which is about kind of my experience with mental health, and it felt like a no-brainer, like I said. Yeah.
Well, you did do something.
This will sound silly from me, but when you call the number, do you have to listen to the song on the phone? Do they play it to you over the phone, or do you get it sent to you like the Crazy Frog ringtone? What's happening?
I mean, it actually is over the phone, but we found a way of getting it so it's actually really good quality.
Right.
But it's definitely not ideal in terms of if you want a pure waveform audio, but it's not hi-fi.
Phone's not hi-fi.
Yeah, it's the best. You know, it's like I said, we're going back in the old days where people had to pay for music and listen to bad quality.
I look forward to a vinyl phone.
Yeah.
Hey, you work incredibly hard. You're always on this tour. You could be forgiven putting your feet up, but on the weekend we saw you on stage with the Aussie band the DMAs. I think you might have a little bit of the vision of that here. What I love about this is they went on their Instagram and they said this was a collab that they described as a test run. Uh-huh. I didn't realise it was an audition. Did you pass?
Kind of, I mean, I don't know. I didn't know they said that either, those guys. It was really cool. We started writing a couple years ago, and we've written so many songs together because we all just kind of get along. We became mates, and this was one of our favorite songs that we wrote. And we just thought we'd give it a test run in front of the crowd. And
did the song pass?
Yeah, I think it did. I mean, I don't think anyone really expected it, especially when you're coming out to. On a stage to a crowd there's not much kind of crossover between our demographics. There is a little bit, but it's a little nerve-wracking, but I think everyone received it well, which is good.
Done. Yeah. Congrats.
Well, you can hear Ruel's new single by calling the Release Line, which is 1300 004 002, and of course, Lifeline is your best bet for crisis support, 1311 14. Ruel, thanks so much for coming in.
Thanks, guys.